Leventerra, Tale of the Winds is an indie 8-bit side-scrolling adventure with pirates. It's now on Kickstarter. I backed it, maybe you will too. I'm Zach Scott, and this is Quick Play. What is up, guys? Zach Scott here, doing a quick play of Leventerra, Tale of the Winds. Now, this is an early alpha build. They are actually doing a Kickstarter for this. This is done by Lasso Games. It's an indie game. It's kind of a Metroidvania-style game. They're going for Castlevania meets Sid Meier's Pirates. And let's do a new game right here, right now. And so basically, this is like an old-school 8-bit style game. I actually played through all that was available right now because this is a Kickstarter game and I Kickstarted it. I wanted to be sure that I wanted to support this game, but I'll tell you, my friend Will, you might know Will, he was in my Minecraft series early on. He and his girlfriend Jenny were both in the Minecraft series, and Will did a ton of the artwork for this game. And so you're going to be able to see that as I play through. This is going to be a quick play, meaning no more than an hour, hopefully. I don't know how long it's going to take. I played through it already, but I did a lot of exploration. And let's go ahead. I'm going to be male. My name is going to be Zach Scott. And so, yeah, you know, I want it to be sure, you know, that, you know, obviously I don't mind, you know, doing favors for friends, but I wanted to be sure that I actually liked the game before doing a video on it. You know, I would have kickstarted it anyway, but before actually doing a video on it and showing it to you guys, I wanted to be sure that I liked the game, so I played all the way through what's available right now. Things look good. Start, enter, confirm. Captain's log, 14-4076. Sloop in MS Trade Wind encounter thunderstorm and run aground. Crew abandoned, moored ship remains on beach of Largo Peninsula. Today I will venture ashore to find the missing crew. Jonathan Crow, Blackjack, and Cooper were spotted jumping overboard. There is still hope. All right. I hope there is hope. All right, Farpoint Beach. Here we go. So yeah, as you can see, 8-bit style graphics, 8-bit style chiptune music. And same with enemies and gameplay in general. There we go. Break open everything, get some stuff. So basically, you break open things, you find gold, you find resources. And basically, when we get to town here, you're going to use the gold and the resources to make trades. And ultimately, the goal of this first part is to fight the bosses, get new weapons, and upgrade your ship. Once the ship is upgraded, I mean, we're pretty much done with the video. Again, this is an early alpha release. This is so polished for an early alpha, and so I'm pretty excited about it. And I kickstarted it, and you guys can too. There's a link in the description. Go check it out, and, you know, support indie games. This is an indie game. Press the sub weapon to throw, yeah. So we have a sub weapon, kind of like, you know, you would in Castlevania. There we go. And I don't know what the crab legs are for, the crab claws or whatever, but these are giant crabs here. And the so basically, yeah, if you like old school style Nintendo NES games, like, this is it. It reminds me a little bit of you know, Castlevania 2, a little bit of Zelda 2, to be honest, because there are towns here, but there are towns in Castlevania 2. And here we go. It's pretty fun. I got through it. There's a lot of adventuring, a lot of resource finding. It's a very cool game, and you're gonna see that as we play through. And we're about to hit town very soon. I'm actually doing a lot better than I was when I started out. And you see, I get gold. If I check out the inventory screen, I get resources that I can use here. There's a time. I don't know what the book is, but there is a time. See the time ticking down in the lower left-hand corner? It actually affects the sky color, and it affects the game minimally so far. I imagine it's going to be a much more important aspect of gameplay in a more fuller build of this. I don't recognize your face, stranger. I'm just really surprised at how polished this was, because I knew that Will had been working on a game, and he's not doing any of the development, he's doing the artwork, but I mean, like, I was just like, wow, you actually found, like, a real game to work for. That's so cool. And so, go in here, and this is cool. It's like a little pub. You can buy ale or turkey legs. I don't really want to buy either right now. Go up here. This part's funny. Drunkard. Have another drink. All right. And then this guy over here. Shall I play you a tune? Yes, Bard, thank you. Thanks for the tune. And so anyway, we're gonna go down here. And yeah, I backed this game. I would love this game to get kickstarted. I would love you guys to back it. You don't have to. It's really cheap though. Just for a build of the game, it's really cheap. So go check out the rates and everything that you can get for it. Health potion, mana potion. Health potions are great, especially at the end of this alpha. But I'm not gonna buy any health potions right now. You actually find some health potions. There's like a bat in that cage up there. Oh my gosh. I love that close after dark. So it just closed. It just now got dark. We were in the transition time when, you know, this became open and then this started closing. Hello, lady. Marissa. Largo Peninsula is known for its clematis flowers. I'm stuttering here. Clematis flowers. What's up? Horizon is a nice place to live. I'd love to see the world, though. Well, you're gonna have to wait until this game gets kickstarted to see the world. I've heard tales of a sorcerer who uses magic to control the weather. The scholars call it Leventerra, which is the title of the game, by the way. The sorcerer stays holed up at a palace on the hill. But I've never been up there. Well, me neither. Now I'm on the rooftops. Yay! And so here's like a store right here. This is a blacksmith. He crafts lightweight tools with iron purchased. Tools are carried in inventory. So, you know, there's a long sword, a pickaxe, a felling axe. You actually get some of these items by fighting enemies and stuff later on. We'll see that. This is a bank. You can store your money here in the bank, which is a great idea because what ends up happening is when you die, you lose all like half the cash on you. So there's no real like penalty for dying other than that, as far as I can, you know, determine, as far as I've seen so far. Winds haven't been quite right lately. And so, yeah, sometimes I'll be walking around with like hundreds of coins on me and I die. I'm like, I lose hundreds of coins. So, oh well. Again, the store here, you can buy materials. The materials are used to upgrade the ship. And let's see. Zach Scott, I can't believe you survived. I did. How did you manage? The beach was docile. The gales came from the northwest. I like how dramatic this part is. The waves were 40 feet tall. When the first white cat battered us, I knew she was through. The MS Trade Wind would be no more. But then, like magic, the deck was beneath my feet again. We hit the rocks and reefs hard, and I was thrown overboard. As my feet went over my head, I saw her hull split open. I watched the wind's fury rend the mainsail in twain. And as my head hit the water, I saw the mainmast crack. As I swam away, I looked back and saw her mighty frame above me. She was beaten, but she wasn't dead. I grabbed an apple barrel and held on for me life. And when I rolled up on Fairpoint, I started making plans to restore her former glory. And if you talk to him again, meet Blackjack at the pier. And so this thing is labeled Pier. I'm not going to give like a ton of suggestions as I play this because I'm talking with the developer. And I mean, I don't have a ton of suggestions anyway. This is a fairly polished alpha. One thing I would like to see is like a little arrow, like a little bouncing arrow to indicate that you could actually go into this pier. It took me a little bit to figure that out. Got resources. I got some wood, got some coins, got some turkey, all that stuff. Now, here is, yeah, there's Blackjack. Blackjack. Zach Scott, ahoy. I knew you'd make it. Me whiskers were tickling. Come find me if you ever need a lift. All right, transport you. Yeah. Okay. So you can actually go in here, and I'm gonna check out if there's anything over here. There's not. Okay. You can actually go in his little boat. Press up. You can go to the Horizon Pier, which we're at right now, or the ship. It's free. So we're in the ship. This is the MS Tradewind. Use the helm to travel and visit the hold to rest. Now, one thing I want to showcase. This is awesome. Look at this. This is, Cirrowin. Use LR, yeah, to turn the ship and, okay, to start, stop. I can't move right now. The reason I can't move is as that guy just explained, I'm underwater now for some reason, hold on. As that guy explained, the ship is damaged, but not beaten. And so you have to like, you know, you could get gold, get the resources, the wood, the wool, the iron. I think those are pelts? I don't know what those are. Skins? I forget. You need all these items to repair, and it's not that hard to get if you just play through the story. So we're gonna go over here, we're gonna check, and you can sleep here, restore your health. I'm gonna go and do it just because, so you can hear the music. And you know, Will did some of the music in this game, or at least composed some of it. I don't know if what we're hearing Will has anything to do with, but a lot of the artwork Will definitely had a lot to do with. So this is I love the style. It's a beautiful game. Let's go see what these guys are selling just out of curiosity. Then we'll get out. Yeah, so I don't quite know I don't know what this is yet. I don't know what these are used for. I'm sure we'll find out later. Cannonballs, I know what those are used for. Those are used to fight when you're in ship mode. Fish, I don't know what fish is for either yet. But we'll, you know, again, eventually, and if you guys have questions, definitely take to the Kickstarter, and there's a link to the Kickstarter, and there's a link to this demo. If you want to play this yourself, there is a demo already released, available for free to the public. Go play it, you know, experience this for yourself, or just continue watching this video. Go kickstart it, though. I really want this to come to fruition. And, winds haven't been quite right lately. More resources. I don't think 9 coins is worth depositing in the bank right now. Now, this is the part where we get enemies. Here we go. Boom! All right, sometimes these guys drop wool. Oh, I already took some damage right there. There we go. And you're like, how do I get up there? Again, being a Metroidvania-style game, you know, all these rooms are interconnected. There's a lot of exploration to do. And so, this is exciting. Whoa! Jeez, that guy ran at me. Some of these guys take 2 hits. Boom, gotcha. Boom, yeah, got some wool. I don't know how to pronounce that. Kari Mines below? Condemned Mine Shaft. That sounds exciting. Let's go check it out. Alright, got him. And look at that. Lo and behold, the Condemned Mine Shaft is locked. So, we gotta get a key somewhere. Where? I don't know yet. We'll find out, though. Boom. Ah, all right. My health is actually pretty low right now. Hopefully I don't lose it. All right, got some health. There we go. And you're wondering, like, oh, hey, how's it going? Fell down the waterfall, eh? Or were you looking for the mines? I was looking for the mines, I guess, technically. Up here. There you go. I love the treasure in this game. Look at this. Boom, it just goes everywhere. Oh, my gosh. And it gave us a health potion. Oh, man. All right, this guy's going to run at us. Got him. Got some more health. Now, I probably have coins. Like, oh, man, I missed some coins up there. Darn it. Okay, well, that's okay. Now, you know, I'm not going to... I do want to go back to the town to store everything, but I don't want to waste your time. I'm going to just try to stay alive. I do have a health potion. Let's progress forward. Unfortunately, we don't have a key for that mine shaft yet. There's a lot of... Oh, my gosh. Okay. I ended up taking damage anyway. And, you know, your inventory can fill up. At least portions of it can, so... You know, but this is good. Getting all these items is good. I don't know if there's any other... Zach Scott, you made it! He got me. No, Cooper, no. A crazed lumberjack. He lunged at me. I did what I could, but I met his blade. Then he took my key to the mines. Why'd you have a key? I'm sorry. I won't be able to make it back. Beware of these woods, Zach Scott. Danger lies ahead. He's dead. No! I will avenge you, Cooper! And here we get into more enemies. Boom. Got him. Got a bunch of gold, too. You'll see. There's going to be a really interesting feature of this game that I like a lot that'll help us deal with our economy and all of the money that we have. And so, let's go up here. Alright, and we're gonna transition. Well, let's not transition quite yet. Let's figure out what... Oh, God, I don't hate, but you know what? I mean, I'm gonna die. Oh, dang it! Okay, so I lost half of my health, or half of my money. That's okay. Honestly, it is. We'll get it back. I'm already at 34. Come on now. Sometimes the penalty isn't as bad as it seems. All right, here we go. Ah, so yeah, see, I can't get up there yet. So I do have to go in this cave. All right, and you may have seen on my Twitter me, like, retweeting some of Will's artwork for this game, like, over the past several weeks. He's been working on the artwork and in the animations and stuff, and I tell you, Will, you've done a good job. Really captured that 8-bit style. I'm gonna try to go up top there. Oh yeah, I do have a sub weapon, but, you know, I'm kinda, the boomerang, when you use it, I should have shown this off. There you go, see? Ah, I missed. Ah, meat fell down. Oh, jeez, okay. He's howling. It's a good sub weapon, as long as you catch it. If you don't catch it, you lose it, so. Let's go in here really quick. I don't think there's... Oh yeah, so there's a path here. I can't quite do anything with that path. Oh man, he's back. Ah! Alright, let's see what we could do. Again, it's becoming nighttime. Not a huge deal. And I can... Alright, just destroy a fish swimming through a stream. Like, gotcha, fish! Alright, let's see. Yeah, I can obviously avoid it, but why bother avoiding it when you can get gold from it, so... Anyway, let's keep going. There's a deer! Come back! Oh, here's the lumberjack boss. Now, with a sub weapon, this guy is not so bad. And he's swinging away at that, getting wood. And that's showing you, that's kind of a tutorial. The forest, it whispers to me words in the wind. What has come over me? You don't belong here. I'm not so bad. Ah. Okay, hold on. I'm going to pick up that wood you dropped. Stand back. You don't want to mess with me, lumberjack. Ah. I'm kind of spamming the sub. He's dead. Leventerra flows through you. You can now perform the back dash and dash techniques. Very cool. I got the key. I also got this. Brandish weapon to swap between. So this is the, I don't know if I can chop down trees. I haven't quite figured out the tree mechanic here. What is this? Ooh, I can't come back from that. Let's, whoa. All right, let's go over here. There we go, and get some wood. Let's see. And it's also a weapon. It's not just a, you know, it's not like in Minecraft when you get the pickaxe and then like it's only really good for, you know, pickaxing. So it's, I mean, you can use it as a weapon, but I mean, this is, it's a viable weapon is what I'm saying. So we got the key to the mines. Ah. There we go. Love it. So this is such a cool, like, I feel like he was no real threat, but whatever. We struck down that deer. Ooh, nice. Oh, jeez. We got hit a little bit. That's okay. Now, there was a side path that I was ignoring, and I don't know why I was ignoring it. Let's go over to it. Was it this? Ah, jeez, he hit me. Oh, jeez. Okay. Okay, I need to be careful. I'm almost... I'll lose, like, half... Like, 40... Almost 45 coins if I keep doing this here. And so, yeah, you can't use the axe on that. You'll see there's a whole other item to use for that. Whoa! Secrets! Look at that. Look at this. This is amazing, is it not? And look how many... Oh, my gosh. If I die... I lose so much. What do I do from here? Oh my god, what do I do from here? I am not... What do I do? Oh, I just jump up. Okay. No! Oh man, I lost over 100 coins. Okay. Well, that's okay. Full health again. Let's just deal with it. Come on. Oh my god. Okay, got a piece of heart back. And over here, there's a guy. Hi. Hi, guy. Gotcha. And I got a health... I should have used the health potion. I don't know why. I'm saving the health potion for the end. The final boss... Oh, come on. No. Okay, so we went and got the treasure. You'll see in a second what I'm going to do. How do I get back to the mines? I think the mines are at the beginning. Let's go back. Yeah, I got some meat. I love old school style games, especially like new games that stay relatively faithful. Obviously, you know, this is widescreen, so it's not like exactly like an NES game. That's okay with me, but it feels the gameplay is faithful, and I love it. It takes me back to my childhood a little bit, but also, you know, this has some, you know, more modern concepts in it that I appreciate, such as like all the resource gathering and everything like that. Oh, no. Boom, gotcha. So we can go down here now into the caves. And we can use the key. Another suggestion that I would like to see is use the key automatically. It took me a little bit of time. You actually go to the inventory and you you use the key. So, which is fine. But, you know, it just took me a little bit of time to figure that out. And I like it. That just taught you right there what those do. Oh, jeez. Oh, God. Okay. I keep losing tons of money. That's, they can't fly for too long. That's okay. Alright, walk across that. Now these guys are hilarious to me. They drop like huge items. Like a huge, that guy turned into like a huge steak. Alright, we're just gonna bypass some of these guys. They're like the stone crabs right there. Now these, you need something else for that. You'll see in the future. But I just like the progression, you know? It's like you discover, and I'm playing through this a lot faster than I played before, but I love like the progression where like you see something and you're like, how do I even do, like what do I do with that? And then you'll find out eventually. So I love the progression. I like, okay. Well, one thing you want to be sure of is check these side rooms, because that's one thing I forgot about when I first played through here. And I didn't even like, you just want to be sure to check. Yeah, oh my God, I got a gym. What's down here? All right, here we go. You're gonna see what I mean by, I can't jump too high there. I forgot to show you the dash. The dash is, you hold this down and then you just like, I'm not actually losing a weapon there. That's just a weird, you hold this down and then you like, yeah, you do like a dash like that. So they're like, the boat guy is here now. He's like, hey, you wanna go back? I'm like, yeah, I wanna go back. Take me back to the pier. And then you can go to the bank then and deposit, you know, what you need to. Or conversely, if you have enough things to upgrade the ship, it may not be a bad idea just to start upgrading the ship right now. Let's go check that out, see if I have anything to do it. Okay, I did that. I don't have iron. I don't have enough of any of those other things, though. So that's good. Let's take a step back. At least I spent some money well. And what else was I needing? I was needing how many? I have 17. No, I have 8 logs. I need 12 logs. So if I just buy 2 more logs. But we might find logs along the way. I'm going to go take me to shore. I'm going to go to the bank really quick. That way I'll have my money stored away and it'll be safe. I think it's safe. I don't know. That would be horrible if it wasn't safe. So go ahead and put all that in my bank really quick. Hopefully he doesn't. If anything, he should be paying me to be, So yeah, so let's go back to the pier. And I'm just gonna, I don't know why I'm jumping. All right, go over here. Go back to the mines. So the mines, we wanna be here. There's a treasure there. I maybe should have looked at the treasure first. Here we go, look at this. I got like, those gems give us like 50 coins. So I'm probably gonna wanna go back to the bank after all this, so. Hold on, I'm gonna try to jump down. No! Oh, man. Okay, I landed in the spikes. All right, we'll just try that again. Not a big deal. And the game design of this is pretty good. I mean, it gives you a nice progression of enemies to deal with. Like, see, I'm dealing with this guy throwing the axes right now, and you'll see that I'll have to deal with something similar in the future, so. All right. So much, oh my gosh. That gem probably just went into the spikes. It did. It's not worth it to try to, you know, get that back and thing, but. You know, look, I already have so much money now. I feel like just going back and depositing the money. Like, I really do. Like, this is just me being me. But I mean, like, that's 200 gems. You go to the ship. No, not the ship. You go to, a shore. There we go. And then, yeah, I'm sorry. I know this might be a little tedious to watch, but I mean, like, if you're playing this and you're in my position, you would do the same thing. So go ahead and put that in the bank. There we go. I have a lot of money in the bank now. And this is good. This is going to be a pretty solid amount in the bank for what we need for the first part. You're not going to be choking for resources when you play this game. And that's what I like about it. Because, you know, I wouldn't want to just have to grind for resources. And they don't make you do that in this game. So that's good. So here we go. This room, I don't know what's with this room. This room looks like I should have some sort of encounter here, but I have it in here instead. All right, but now this boss fight took me a little while to figure out. Are you lost, little one? I've got a surprise for you. You will never again see the light of day. Now this guy's all about patterns. He throws this like weapon at first, and then he starts throwing axes. And then he stomps, and the ceiling kind of starts falling. And so you gotta like hope that it hits him, and then when he's stunned, then you hit him. You do like a ton of damage when that happens. So, and then he does another attack like that. All right, so same thing, same setup here. Axes come at you now. And he's gonna stomp. Ah, I keep getting hit by that. I'm gonna actually take a heal potion. Because I don't want to have to redo this one. Alright, he's gonna throw the... Here he goes. This is a... Basically, like, this is kind of like a, you know, Zelda Mario style boss where he has like a pattern. And then, you know, three hits, he's done for. Ah, see, that missed him, though. That's unfortunate. That's unfortunate that missed him right there. You're gonna wait. You gotta jump over him and hope that those things fall on him. The axes are next. Stomping will be next. All right, got him. Boom. All right. Collect Lev Orbs to recharge your sub-weapon ammunition. Now, for this weapon, this is the... This is my sub weapon, and so if I use it, I can't use it. Okay. And this is my new. If I switch, I have a new pickaxe now. So I got the Lev Orbs, and basically what this does is, for you know, the boomerang, you can use it until you just don't catch it. And I'll give you an example of that really quick. If I pick up this sub weapon, I use it. What if I don't catch it? Like. Oh, it's gone forever. But this sub-weapon uses the Lev Orbs, so that's pretty cool. And now that we have a pickaxe, we can actually break the walls. We can some of these things that you've seen here. They're like, how do I get in here? Boom! Iron right there. That's a good resource. What does it say? Lower path. Sure. Let's try the lower path. I don't know. Oh, hey! It's Crow. Zach Scott. How did you make it this far? Hey, you don't have much confidence in me, buddy. I followed Captain Nathaniel all the way through these mines. There's a huge castle above us. Captain Nate went in, but the door closed behind him. I couldn't get it open. I'll head back to shore. I'll bet Jonathan needs a hand with repairs. And when we set sail, I'll be your lookout. If you do go after Captain Nate, tread lightly. I think there's dirty work afoot up there. All right, Crow enables you to see other ships' hull integrity and allegiances at sea. Cool, thanks, Crow, buddy. And I don't know, you know, I want to get this treasure, obviously. Got him. Look at all this. Now, when I played through before, I never took the upper path. I'm curious what the upper path looks like. Let's go up here. So yeah, this game actually provides multiple paths to do, like, to get to the same places, which I really do appreciate. What's this? Upper path. Well, what's over here in general? A lot of stuff. Yes, break it open. I've taken the lower path before. I'm kind of curious to see what the upper path's all about. Iron. And any resources that you don't end up collecting all the way through, you're gonna be able to purchase them with gold, so... You know, if you happen, oh, look at that. What is that? Oh my gosh. I have so many coins now. Oh wow. I didn't even know this was here. I didn't see this last time. I love how the coins just shoot out of the treasure chest. Oh my gosh, 600. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. Okay. That is a lot. I was not expecting to have that much. Whoa, that crab went on the attack. All right, let's go ahead and, All right, the upper path might be appealing, I don't know. Yeah, I have not gone this way. All right, be careful. Be careful, Zach, I'm talking to myself. Again, this is a new experience for me because I took the lower path last time. Seemed fine. All right, got that. What are we doing? Huh. Well, okay. I don't know what the crab claws are for. I haven't figured that out yet. Oh, not quite high enough. All right. And I don't know if I ever saw the guy that they mentioned who went to the castle. I don't know if I've ever seen that guy. So, we may not rescue him in this video. Whoever that guy is, I don't know. Oh, jeez. Oh, my gosh. I fell really far. Break that wall. I'm afraid of taking this. Oh, no. It's not a big deal. There we go. Got some iron. Whoa. That was going to take me into the spikes. Who's going to, like... You jerk, you're going to carry me into the spikes. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Okay. Whew. Close call again, right? I don't like the way you look, bats. Why did I even do that? Okay, here we go. All right. Take us up. Oh, wait. Oh, wow. More... Oh, my gosh. I should really just go back to town if I can. Oh, this is beautiful. Look at all this. I have like over 1,000 coins. If I die, oh my god. I'm just gonna do a potion. I can't die right now. I have too many coins. There we go. Oh boy. The stakes are high. Oh no, no. There we go. Okay, the stakes are really high. I'm carrying so much money on me right now. I do not want to die. That's okay. That's okay. We got this though, right? All right, here we go. So yeah, I don't know if there is a guy in the castle like waiting to be rescued or not, because when I played through before, and again, I played through this before because I didn't want to like, you know, I didn't want to give you like a video of a game, you know, and encourage you to kickstart something without, you know, without knowing for sure. Like I said, I would kickstart something myself as a favor to a friend, but I wouldn't like subject everyone to it as a favor. So I do like this game. I'm pretty excited about, you know, seeing how it plays out. Which way do we need to go? This way. There we go. Okay. Sometimes it's an adventure trying to find your way around. Oh, so I think I have full iron right now. All right, this is cool. This is like another town over here. This is a very small town. If you don't mind, I like to drink in peace. Well, sure, go ahead. And I don't know what kind of, if I'm missing any secrets, only advanced ships can cross maelstroms. Is that what, maelstroms? I don't even know how to say that word. We don't get many visitors around here. And look, my boat guy's here. Thankfully, I'm gonna go back to the pier. I'm gonna go to the ship and see if I can repair the ship. This is a huge incentive to repair the ship. Hey buddy, what do we have? All right, we don't have a mast or sails. I can actually completely repair the ship right now, I believe. I wanna go ashore. What am I missing? I need more wood and probably more animal, whatever those furs. I think those are furs. So over here, he's selling wood. I'm full now on wood. And you are selling furs. What do I need? I need a wool. There we go. Now I'm carrying too much wool. The rest, though, I mean, like, I'm going to put, like, half of this in the bank. I don't even know. Here we go. This is going to be good for me, I think. Let's get an even 1,000 in the bank. Draw my interest, you know. You know what I'm saying? All right. Go back to the pier. And yeah, so this is see, like I said, it's not, they're not going to like make you grind to get all the stuff for the ship. That would be kind of annoying. But they don't. So that's good. All right, the ship is repaired. And now this is so cool. Check this out. Now I can drive around. And now I won't now obviously this is an incomplete game. This is an alpha. So, you know, the maelstroms or whatever, however you say that word, is up there. I can dock here at this lighthouse and go in. This is an incomplete town though, if we want to check it out. You want to go ashore? Yes. This is an incomplete town. You know, this is not ready for prime time, but I'll show you a little bit. There's some guys here. This is like a whole new village that, you know, you were only going to see here. Not here. You could get the demo, obviously, and see it, but... I would need to go somehow... What am I saying? Oh, man, I died. I would need to go get the axe or whatever. Let's go back. This is not, I mean, you're not going to see much. So we basically, at the end of that room, there's just a locked area, and then that's it. So I need to go, yeah, let's go back. Here we go. Let me just steer back really quick. We dock here and then go ashore. So we're back here. We need to go back to that new village, the Wexel Village. This is where we're heading towards the castle. This is like we're near the end of the alpha here. I love the music here. Hey, buddy. This guy reminds me of the Resident Evil guy, Resident Evil 4. I got what you need. You don't really. I don't need those. I mean, bombs seem cool. I you know, if I would have brought my money with me, I could have bought some bombs. That would have been really interesting. And maybe I should do that, but I think we can make it by without bombs. What's up here? I want to find that guy. Whoever they were talking about. I don't know what their names were. Did he say that someone was here in the castle? Because I've not seen him. Here we go. We can, I'm probably not going to go back to the town, because once we go back to town, nothing changes about the town other than the fact that you've repaired your ship and you can go forward. But this guy is so funny over here. Doot, doot. I love that skeleton. Okay. Anyway, let's go in. So we're in here now. We got some strong enemies here. We really do. And I'm going to try to progress forward. I love blobs like this. These type of blobs are in lots of video games. I love blobs like that. I don't know why. Now this guy is—he's real trouble. He's a knight, but this move that just is just crazy devastating. You want to watch out for him. Yeah. Okay. You got me. Oh God. Okay. I'm almost dead. Let's see if I can make it. If I die, that's okay. I'll risk death. Oh wait, wait, wait. What? Oh yeah. I'm out here now. A couple different paths here. Alright, take that guy out. I feel like I do not want to fight you. Obviously, my sub weapon can go reach him. If I want it to, I don't really want to. I don't want to waste my 11 orbs or whatever they're called. Alright, that actually leads just out. If I've done that, I was like, what's over there? I'll just jump it, see what happens. Alright, got him. Beautiful, got him. Now there's gonna be a treasure. No, it's not. Oh, okay, I thought there was a treasure chest down there. Maybe there should have been. Maybe it's a little bit of a. Alright, got things. Stuff. The treasure chest over here. Yes. I really just want health potions at this moment. I can go buy health potions from the town, but you know, I don't want to take up too much of your time. All right. I don't even know, man. Oh, jeez. Okay. And more 11 orbs. Such a weird name. Ah, I would like to not take damage every time I go through there. Alright, there's a health potion. Oh, ow, God. Okay, that scared me. The skeleton just fell. I really wish I had a boomerang right now. I guess I could have bought it from that guy, the dealer outside. All right, or gotten bombs. I mean, I've never even used the bombs before. I guess I don't need. I mean, I could just go back and try to get them, but I mean, all right, here we go. This is weird. Yeah, it takes us back here. Okay, this is like the ending area right here. I'm gonna explore after the end. I'm gonna explore just a little bit more when I have the freedom to. Unfortunately, like, what do I do? Hold on, I'm gonna skip it for a second. I'm gonna actually look this way just a little bit. This is the other path that you can take. This path's a lot harder. I'm just trying to see if I can maybe get some hearts or something. Yeah, I don't even wanna go this way. All right, let's, here we go. We're gonna go ahead and make it. Let's just go fight the boss. We have 29 11 orbs. Let's do it. It's like Simon. All right, red, blue. All right. This was a different pattern when I did it the first time. All right. Okay, I guess I forgot to click it the second time. All right, now here we go. I'm gonna probably use, I'm gonna use a lot of health potions, or I'm gonna, maybe. I don't know, I'll be willing to die the first time, I think, unless I get really far. I don't care about losing my money right now, because I have like 1,000 in the bank. The blue guy, in my opinion, is the hardest, so. Oh, never mind, the red guy's here. Oh, jeez, okay, yeah. This part's hard. I mean, I can't really get through without using potions. Thankfully, they don't make me do the Simon thing again. If I can just get a few hits on blue, I'm happy to start out with. Ah, jeez. Okay. Okay. Hi. Oh, jeez. Okay. Red blocks these, which is super annoying. There we go. I got rid of blue. Green's not so bad. Green has, like, this weird blob effect. Oh, but I need to probably heal. I think like one hit and I'm dead. I forget how much damage these guys do. There we go, got him, I don't need to heal now. Got two little half hearts. Red does a great job at blocking, unfortunately. This is his thing. This guy doesn't do so good at blocking. All right, now this is like the ghosts of all of them come together and they form as one. This part's really cool. All right, now this boss has all their powers. He's not so hard, but he does have all their powers, so he'll block what I throw at him. Unfortunately. You'll see him, like, you know, lash out at me, try to maybe use, like, lightning or the green stuff. I'm actually, oh, jeez, see? That thing came at me. I'm gonna have to heal, like, if I get hit one more time. Okay, I'm healing. There we go. I healed. I'm just gonna try to go, oh no, I gotta heal, I'm sorry. All right, there we go, there we go, got him. I didn't know I could take him out in just one more hit like that. I may have not healed. I get so much stuff. This concludes the demo. Feel free to explore the world. Thank you for playing. Now they were talking about, I don't know what that is. Oh, the silver compass allows Zach Scott to perform magic. Whoa, what? The heck is this? Okay, so I don't know. I've never checked out the magic yet. The heck is magic? Oh, holy moly. I did not know. That is so cool. Wow. And so I have mana now. You know, I didn't even check that out. I guess I didn't even pick up the silver compass, the first playthrough. So there we go. So I can do magic now. That's pretty cool. So I got the fireball spell. I got the... that's probably the worst. I mean, worst as in, like, the most devastating. I'm gonna go down this other path. I died going up this path so many times. Oh, see, I already went this way. Oh, no, that's not what I want to do. South, let's go south. So now I guess I'll be looking out for mana. I don't know where I get mana from. All right, yeah, I know. Okay, hold on. Boom, right through it. Ow. Now I'm out of mana. Oh my god. I have so much money. Not that it matters. This is just a demo. I'm not going to be able to... Oh man, I don't like you, Blue. So yeah, I just wanted to see if there's any... Oh god, okay. So it doesn't punish you as much. There's a treasure chest here. Yes. You know, like in a Castlevania game, it doesn't punish you as much if you, if you fall in some of these stages, so that's good. Again, I'm really just, I wanna go check out the bombs. It's like the only other thing I haven't done yet in this game. Oh my god. Yep, hi. Oh, darn it, I was trying to slip past him. All right, so, if you guys like what you see here, and you don't mind spending a few bucks kickstarting a game, just to, you know, you can spend as little as you want kickstarting a game, I think as little as a dollar, but you're gonna get some cool stuff. Okay, here we go. I want to see this guy over here selling this. Here we go. I've never... Bombs. Many thanks. You're welcome. So now I have bombs. Nice. And then if we go over here to where the skeleton was, we're just going to end up going back. I guess one more thing that I can show you is go back on the ship. And again, just kind of give you a little hint of the gameplay. I mean, apparently this is the part where the game, the action really starts. Once you beat this part, then you're free to go everywhere, or at least it's what's planned. Go to the ship, then we start steering, and let's go. And you see, like, there are certain boundaries that I can't do, and there's that lighthouse area, which I can't get past either. But you see there's, like, a ship there? Like, look at this. Oh, wait. Look. Hold on. Sorry. I can shoot cannonballs. And there's actually a, there's like a tower down here that shoots at me. I can get close to it and take it out. Hold on. All right. Got him. Okay, so, and you can also battle these other ships apparently. I haven't done it yet, but you can apparently do that. Hey, buddy. Uh-oh. Is he mad? Hold on. Come here. You don't want to mess with me. I got cannonballs. All right, so I shot down a ship. I don't know what that does, but that's going to be part of the gameplay. And there's a whole map here. Look at this. A whole map. There's going to be a lot of stuff to do, I'm sure. They're a pirate ship. Oh man, I'm out of cannonballs. Oh, I'm out of cannonballs. Okay. So anyway, well, I don't know what happens when you take care of the. Oh my god. Anyway, so thanks for watching, guys. If you like what you see, feel free to kickstart this game. What does he say now? I'll be here in the hold if you need me. I need to rest me bones, Blackjack, and help you get to shore. So yeah, go kickstart this. There's a link in the description. There's also a link to the demo if you want to play this for yourself. Just get a good feel for the game. I feel like it's very polished, especially for an alpha. But I would love you guys to kickstart this. And so this is a good ending point. Thanks for watching. Come back next time for more quick plays. And I'll see you then. Goodbye. I'm Zach Scott. Subscribe if you have not. If you like this video and want to help this channel grow, all you got to do is click the like button below. Thanks so much for watching. Check out more of my videos. And if you want to find me on your favorite social network, check the links in the description. And here's Otto. What's he gone? Those are my cats.